That was an ant, by the way. But from the Message Bible, Jeremiah chapter 8, and I'm going to start around verse number 4. It says, tell them this, God's message. Do people fall down and not get up? Or take the wrong road and then just keep going? So why does this people go backward and just keep on going backward? They stubbornly hold on to their illusions and refuse to change direction. God said, I listened carefully, but I heard not so much as a whisper. No one expressed one word of regret. Not a single I'm sorry did I hear. They just kept at it, blindly and stupidly, banging their heads against a brick wall. Cranes know when it's time to move south for the winter. And the robins and the warblers and the bluebirds, they know when it's time to come back again. But my people know nothing. Not the first thing of God and his rule. How can you say we know the score? We're the proud owners of God's revelation. Look where it's gotten you. Stuck in illusion. Your religion experts have taken you for a ride. Let me read that one again. Your religion experts have taken you for a ride. They have taken you for a ride. You know it alls will be unmasked. Caught. And your know it alls will be unmasked. Caught and shown up for what they are. Look at them. They know everything but God's word. You call that knowing? So here's what's going to happen to all the know it alls. I'll make them wifeless and homeless. Everyone's after the dishonest God. Little people and big people alike. Prophets and priests and everyone in between. Twist words and doctor truth. This is what I want y'all to get. Get my stuff together for me, Minister Steve. All my stuff I need over here. My dear daughter, my people, broken, shattered, and yet they put on band-aids. Come on, son. My people, broken, shattered, yet they put on band-aids. My people. Broken. Shattered.
My Lord. Yeah.
And yet they put on band-aids. Saying, it's not so bad. It's it right there.
My Lord.
You'll be just fine. But things aren't just fine. Do you suppose they're embarrassed over this outrage? Not really. They have no shame. They don't even know how to blush. There's no hope for them. They hit bottom, and there's no getting up. And as far as I'm concerned, they're finished. God has spoken. I went out to see if I could salvage anything, but found nothing. Not a grape, not a fig, just a few withered leaves. Now, you know I get in trouble preaching about that because I seem to recall a story. Jesus walking down a road, runs up on a fig tree, had leaves, no fruit. I'm just saying. He says, I'm taking back everything I gave them. Now let me jump to the King James. I don't have to read that 14 through 16 like that. Says, why do we, now here's the people talking. Why do we sit still? Assemble yourselves and let's enter into the defensed city and let us be silent there. For the Lord our God has put us to silence and give us water of gall to drink because we have sinned against the Lord. We looked for peace, but no good came. And for a time of health, and behold, trouble. The snorting of his horses was heard from Dan. The whole land trembled at the sound of the name of his strong ones, for they are come and have devoured the land and all that is in it, the city and those that dwell therein. Now let me jump back to the Message Bible. I got past the part I didn't want to read now. And then it says, verse 18, it says, well, 17. He says, what's more, I'm dispatching poisonous snakes among you. Snakes that can't be charmed. Snakes that will bite you and kill you. God's decree. I drown in grief. I'm heartsick. Oh, listen. Please listen. Is the cry of my dear people reverberating through the country. Is God no longer in Zion? Has the king gone away? This one. Can you tell me why they flaunt their plaything gods? They flaunt their plaything gods. Their silly, imported no gods before men. The crops are in. The summer is over. But for us, nothing's changed. We're still waiting to be rescued. For my dear people, my dear broken people, I'm heartbroken. I weep. Seized by grief. King James says, is there no balm in Gilead? It says, is there a doctor? Message says, isn't there a doctor in the house? So why can't something be done to heal and save my dear, dear people? Father, as I speak your word tonight, I pray that tonight would not be a time of entertainment, but it would be a time of conviction. Deal with us, oh God. Help me to clearly articulate the truths of your word. I pray that the hearts of everyone here is receptive to hear and to receive. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
On your way down, I'd like to have you repeat with me my subject for the night. Do y'all mind helping me repeat my subject tonight? Lord, heal me. Let me add something to that. Let me just add something. Lord, heal me for real. I was sitting at my computer yesterday. And I began to get all kinds of bad news about things that were going on in the body of Christ. And it was disturbing. I sat at my computer and I began to cry. Because first, before I looked at anybody else, I looked at me. And as much as I try to be a man of God and walk with God and live holy, I still see some stuff in long. Y'all can be deep if you want to. I still see some stuff in long that I need God to deal with in me. And so, as I wept, I began to think, and God began to speak to me. And he began to speak to me, and he said, my people are on medicine to maintain. Come in. The preachers are giving the people maintenance medicine. Somebody shout maintenance.
Maintenance.
The outside of this bottle says amoxicillin, clavicin. I'm not medical, so I don't know. But when I took it to the hospital with me to the ER, they said, oh, that's augmented. Which is a very strong, the level they had me on was a very strong antibiotic. Now that's what it says on the outside of the bottle. Now, here's the problem. This is what the church looks like right now. Some of y'all didn't really see how jacked up the church is. Not one, but both ankles, both feet, jacked up. When both of your ankles are weak, you struggle to stand. Oh, I can't get a church right there. When both of your ankles are weak, we haven't even made it to walk yet, you struggle just to stand.
That's right.
Not only are both of his ankles wrapped up, but he's got something going on with his knees. Got a brace on. Perhaps he struggles to spend time. He's got difficulty using his knees. Sounds to me a lot like the body of Christ. Knee problem. Arm in a swing. Now I couldn't put him in a whole cast, but y'all get the picture. They put you in a sling when your stuff is broken. Fingers in splints. Heart bleeding. This is what the church looks like today. And our preachers are handing us maintenance medicine. Now, we're going to pretend like this isn't a augmentin or antibiotic bottle. We're going to act like it's a painkiller. Oh, I feel like preaching it here. Painkiller. And he hands us the painkiller week after week after week. Go ahead. You need some help. Because I need to get you taking this medication. He's taking his medication, and then he's going back home. He's taking his medication. Take your medication. He's coming to Bible study. Taking his medication. He's coming to Sunday morning service. Might as well keep it in your hands. Taking his medication. He's going to revival. I feel like preaching. Going to revival. After revival. Taking his medication. This is what the body of Christ looks like.
Yes, come on, man.
Come on. What I didn't tell you was how he got in this condition. I can't get to talk about church there. Where his head is bleeding. All you know is you see his head bleeding. The truth of the matter is you don't even know what's really wrong. Because you see the head bleeding on the outside, but chances are before the head ever started bleeding on the outside, there was some kind of trauma to the head on the inside. Y'all gonna help me preach it here tonight?
Come on.
What are you trying to say, Lord? In the body of Christ right now, we are judging what we see on the outside, but there's a whole lot of stuff going on in the inside of us that you cannot see.
Yes.
We don't know what got him here. Maybe, let me talk from a very practical standpoint. Maybe he was treated badly by somebody
in the church.
In the church.
Yeah.
Okay, can I preach like I feel it tonight? Maybe.
Maybe
his daddy walked away from him. Doesn't have a relationship with his father. You see him bleeding, but you don't know the trauma that caused this on the inside before it ever started bleeding. There are some people sitting in here right now. You've got trauma on the inside. People may not see you bleeding on the outside, but there's trauma on the inside. People don't want to be honest in church. We'd rather lie and cover it up. But there's coming a point in all of our lives where the stuff that we're really dealing with, if we don't get healed for real, it's going to start bleeding from the outside, from the inside, and it's going to start bleeding out. And there comes a point when enough blood starts coming out, you can't hide. Maybe somebody he loved
that said, I'm with you, bruh. Turned around and walked away. Trauma to the head. Now let me help you with the trauma to the head. The trauma to the head can be a challenge in the fact that now you may deal with something called unforgiveness. Unforgiveness, well, listen to this, unforgiveness puts a bad memory on repeat. On repeat in our lives. So over and over and over again, we keep reliving the same pain over and over and over again. And the problem is, when we have unforgiveness that sets in, it takes a root called bitterness, and it travels not just from your head, but down to your heart. We wonder why we struggle. Let's be honest. Many of us struggle to really love like we're supposed to love. I want to be honest. We struggle to love like we're supposed to love. Now let me just set the atmosphere straight right here. You don't walk in love for real where you can treat people good that treat you good.
That's right.
Y'all not gonna holler back then.
Come on, say it.
You're not showing the love of God when you respond well to people who say, I love you, Doc. I love you, sis. That Bible says that we're to do good to them that do evil to us. Do good to them that despitefully use us. Love them.
That's right.
When was the last act of kindness you committed towards your enemy? I can't hear nobody now. When was the last act of kindness you deliberately did for your enemy? No, what we'd rather say is I just ain't got nothing to do with
them.
If they came to town and they didn't have a place to stay, you wouldn't even help them get a hotel room. You'd rather them stay on the streets because they did you wrong. But you say you got the love of God. Chances are what was here has now migrated and is happening down here.
That's right.
All right, sir.
How say you do you have the love of Christ? You can't even love the folk you see. Well, let me just give you a secret. They're not going to come to know Christ if they can't see Christ in you. And the real Christ, the Bible said, while we were yet sinners, while we were